If the first panel raised all sorts of challenges we face, the second panel is going to express the democratic possibilities and potentials, not quite, but it's going to be looking at two sets of actors and activities which express certain democratic but also some potentially undemocratic potential. We're going to be looking at the role of social movements and the kind of activities they engage in and how that shaped and shapes the digital. And we're also going to be looking at the way that digital has been used by what you might call democratic designers, people who are actually trying to create avenues and mechanisms for citizens to increase and deepen citizen participation in the political process of digital rights. So I'm really pleased to introduce four great speakers. Anastasia Varda is from the University of Westminster, although we never see each other because she's in Harrow. Westminster actually isn't in Westminster anywhere, as far as I can tell. She's going to be talking about transparency, knowledge, and the commons in social movements. She runs an MA in media, campaigning, and social change, which means micro-targeting for good, I think. And she's co-director of CAMRI, which is the Communication and Media Research Institute. And I really recommend signing up for their newsletter if you're interested in this area. Some really interesting things in there. Hans Hassenbaum is one of my excellent PhD students. He's doing a PhD on democracy, anonymity, and participatory spaces in the digital age. He's actually done all the legwork on this, so I want to thank Hans at this moment for the work he's done.
Thank you.
Last London appearance before moving to a one-year job in Potsdam. Michelle Brook is the Managing Director of the Democratic Society. DevSoc is one of a small number of really active organisations in the UK who are trying to create new spaces for citizen engagement, and she's a particular specialist in the digital aspects of their work and how that can enable greater civic participation, looking towards more effective government accountability and the questions about government information, open data, those sorts of areas. And she's going to talk a bit about some of the challenges they face and some of the ways they've not only been successful, but some of the approaches they've taken to using the digital in that field. And finally, Ricky Dean is from the Goethe University, Frankfurt, later London, and he's going to be talking about citizen participation in digital era governance. Ricky's, as many of you know, is really interesting in that he works on the interface between democratic theory and public administration theory and practice. And he's recently started turning his attention to those of us who work in democratic innovations. I think you probably agree, Michelle, you do agree, is that most of us were schooled in face-to-face interactions, you know, things like participatory budgeting and deliberative mini-publics, those sorts of things, and actually we've come late to the game to thinking about what this means in terms of the online. So it's really refreshing that we're starting to make that orientation. So I'm going to start off, we're going to have a couple of presentations on social movements. We'll start with Anastasia. Thank you, Anastasia. I'll start waving at you if you
Yes, I think you need to.